Hello children, welcome to the class. Today let us study the first unit of geography, India position and extension. This year you are going to study about the Indian geography, both physical and human geography. In this lesson we are going to discuss about the location of India in Asia and the world, the extent and frontiers of India, neighboring countries of India and administrative divisions of India. Before going to study this lesson, we have to recall some geographical aspects which you have learnt in previous classes, because these aspects are very essential to study this lesson as well as the other lessons. Children, look at this picture. This is the picture of globe. In this picture you are observing the horizontal lines which are parallel to each other. These lines are called as latitudes. See, latitudes are imaginary lines which are drawn on the globe for our study purpose. This is 0° latitude. See, the latitudes are measured in degrees. The distance between one latitude to another latitude is divided into 60 minutes. The 0° latitude is called as equator. This latitude divides the earth into equal two parts, and these two parts are called as hemispheres. From 0° to 90° north latitude is called as northern hemisphere. From 0° latitude to 90° south is called as southern hemisphere. Children, look at this picture. In this picture you are observing the vertical lines. These vertical lines are joining the North Pole and the South Pole. These vertical lines are called as longitudes. So, longitudes are the imaginary lines which joins North Pole and South Pole. And the 0° longitude is called as prime meridian. From 0° longitude to 180° longitude in the east is called as eastern hemisphere, and from 0° to 180° west is called western hemisphere. The latitudes and longitudes are very important, because to locate any place on the earth, latitudes and longitudes are very important. Children, now let us know about which are the important latitudes and temperature zones. The knowledge of important latitudes and the temperature zone is very important to study the other lessons. Children, the 0° latitude is called as equator, and the 23.5° north latitude is called as Tropic of Cancer, and 23.5° south latitude is called as Tropic of Capricorn. And the area between the Tropic of Cancer and the Tropic of Capricorn is called as torrid zone or tropical zone. The 66.5° north latitude is called Arctic Circle, and 66.5 degree south latitude is called as Antarctic Circle, or the zone between the 23.5 degree north to 66.5 degree north latitude is called as North Temperate Zone, and the zone between 23.5 degree south latitude and 66.5 degree south latitude is called South Temperate Zone, and the 90 degree north is called as North Pole, and 90 degree south is called South Pole. The area between Arctic Circle and North Pole is North Frigid Zone, and the area between the Antarctic Circle and the South Pole is South Frigid Zone. Now let us know the geographical location of India. Means, what is the location of India in the earth? Observe this picture. This is northern hemisphere from 0 degree to 90 degree north. It is northern hemisphere, and from 0 degree to 90 degree south is southern hemisphere. We have already learnt this. India is here. Observe this one. This is western hemisphere and this is eastern hemisphere. Where is India here? India is here. Now you can tell me what is the geographical location of India. Children, observe this map. And where is India? This is India. Now tell me the location of India. Geographically, India is located within both northern hemisphere and eastern hemisphere. Now let us know the location of India in Asia. Look at the world map. Where is Asia? This is Asia. Asia is the largest continent in the world. And in Asia, where is India? Can you locate India here? This is India. Now tell me, what is the position of India in Asia? Yes, you are right. India is situated in South Asia. India is situated in South Asia, and India is a peninsula. You know what is peninsula? Geographically, India is called as peninsula. Pariyaya Dvipa. What is peninsula? Peninsula is a land which is covered by land in one side and water in three sides. India is a peninsula because India has land border in the north and India has water border in the west, in the east, and in the south. India has Arabian Sea in the west, Bay of Bengal in the east, and Indian Ocean in the south. So, India is a peninsula. Now, let us know the latitudinal and longitudinal extent of India. See, the main land of India extends from 8 degree 4 minutes to 37 degree 6 minutes north latitude. I have already told you the latitudes are measured in degrees. The distance between the each latitude is divided into minutes. So, we have to read this as 8 degree 4 minutes. The mainland of India extends from 8 degree 4 minute north latitude to 37 degree 6 minute north latitude. Remember this, both are north latitude. 8 degree 4 minute latitude is in the south of India, but it is north latitude. Why? Because India is situated in the northern hemisphere. So, both the latitudes are north latitudes. And the longitudinal extent of India. India extends from 68 degree 7 minute east longitude to 97 degree 25 minutes east longitude. These are both east longitudes because India is in eastern hemisphere. And the Andaman and Nicobar Islands extend further southwards and add to India's latitudinal extent. The southernmost point of India is Indira Point. Observe the map. It is located in the Nicobar Island at 6 degree 45 minutes north latitude. It is located in the Nicobar Island. This is the southernmost point of India. And the northern tip of India is Indira Col. The northern tip of India is Indira Col. You have to learn to locate both the tip, both southern tip and northern tip of India. The southern tip is Indira Point, located in Nicobar Islands, and the northern tip of India is located in Indira Col at 37 degree 6 minutes north latitude, and it is located in Ladakh. Indira Col is in Jammu and Kashmir. While the printing of textbook, the Jammu and Kashmir was given as the status of state, and now it is divided into two union territories as Ladakh and Jammu and Kashmir. So now it is situated in Ladakh. Children, now let us know about which is the important latitude which passes through India. Tell me children, which is the important latitude? You have learnt which are the important latitudes and what is the latitudinal extension of India. It is 23.5 degree north latitude. See, 23.5 degree north latitude, it is called as the Tropic of Cancer. It passes through the middle of the country. And 82.5 degree east longitude is very important longitude. It is the central meridian of India. Why it is important? Because Indian standard time is based on this longitude. See, the time is fixed on longitudes. It is called meridian. Meri means mid. Dian means day. The places where the longitude passes, all the places receives the sun rays vertically at the same time, and it is midday, 12 noon. So the longitude is called as meridian. 82.5 degree east longitude is central meridian of India. So the Indian standard time is calculated on the basis of this longitude. See, each longitude has the local time, but to avoid the confusion for administrative purpose and to do all the activities in a country, one time is fixed. Whole country should follow the same time. So, when the 82.5 degree receives the sun rays vertically, that time is set as 12 noon in the whole country. So, this is the standard meridian of India. 82.5 degrees central meridian of India. What is the rank of India in the world with regarding the area? You know this. India is the 7th largest country in the world after Russia, Canada, China, the USA, Brazil and Australia. See, Russia is the largest country in the world and Canada is the second one and China is the third largest and the USA is the fourth largest country and Brazil is the fifth largest country and Australia is the 6th largest country and India is the 7th largest country in the world. India has a total area of 32,87,263 square kilometers. It accounts for only 2.42% of the world's total area. India is the second largest country in the world with regarding the population, but it accounts only 2.42% of the world's total area. The east to west extent of India is over 2,933 kilometers. From the north to south extent is 3,214 kilometers. It is from 8 degree 4 minutes north latitude to 37 degree 6 minutes north latitude. Children, let us know the frontiers of India. You have already studied that India is a peninsula. As India is a peninsula, India has both land and water frontiers. In the north, it has land frontier, and in the west, south, and in the east, it has water frontiers. The land frontier of the country is about 15,200 kilometers. And except in some places, India has natural frontiers almost on all sides. In the north, it is the Himalayan ranges. Observe the picture. The Himalayan ranges form the natural frontiers in the north between India and China. Now, let us know the water frontier of India. We have already discussed this. India has water frontiers about 6,100 kilometers. This is the water frontier of mainland of India. India has islands also. The total length of India's coastline, including the Andaman and Nicobar Islands and the Lakshadweep, it is 7,516.5 kilometers. The Arabian Sea in the west, the Indian Ocean in the south, and the Bay of Bengal in the east. These are the water frontiers of India, and they are also natural frontiers. See, Himalayan mountains, Arabian Sea, and the Indian Ocean and the Bay of Bengal are the natural frontiers of India. Now let us know about the neighboring countries of India. How many neighboring countries India has? India has 7 neighboring countries. Pakistan and Afghanistan are to the northwest. Nepal, Bhutan and China are to the north. Bangladesh and Myanmar are to the east. And to the southeast, Sri Lanka, which is separated from the mainland of India by the Pak Strait and the Gulf of Mannar. Pakistan, Afghanistan, Nepal, Bhutan, China, Bangladesh, Myanmar, Sri Lanka. These are the 7 neighboring countries of India. Children, do you know this? The boundary line between India and Pakistan is called as Radcliffe line. And the boundary line separating India from Afghanistan is the Durand line. And the boundary line between India and China is the McMahon line. Children, let us know about the administrative division of India. You know that India is a democratic republic. India has federal system. So, India is divided into 28 states and 8 union territories, which includes the national capital territory of Delhi. At present, India has 28 states and 8 union territories, and Delhi is the national capital territory. States of India. Observe the map. You have to locate all the states. See, Andhra Pradesh, Assam, Arunachal Pradesh, Bihar, Chhattisgarh, Goa, Gujarat, Haryana, Himachal Pradesh, Jharkhand, Karnataka, Kerala, Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra, Manipura, Meghalaya, Mizoram, Nagaland, Odisha, Punjab, Rajasthan, Sikkim, Tamil Nadu, Telangana, Tripura, Uttarakhand, Uttar Pradesh and West Bengal. See, these are the 28 states of India. You have to learn to mention all the 28 states as well as to locate all the 28 states in India map. And now let us have a glance on the union territories. See, Andaman Nicobar Islands, Chandigarh, Dadra and Nagar Haveli and Daman and Diu, Delhi, Jammu and Kashmir, Lakshadweep, Ladakh and Puducherry. These are the 8 union territories of India. Children, you have to know this. In November 2019, the Government of India introduced legislation to merge the union territories of Daman and Diu and Dadra and Nagar Haveli into a single union territory to be known as Dadra and Nagar Haveli and Daman and Diu, effective from 26 January 2020. That's why in your textbook it is given 9 union territories in India. At present there are 8 union territories in India. Among the states, Telangana is the new state formed on 2nd June 2014. Which is the largest state in India? Observe the map and tell me, which is the largest state in India? Rajasthan is the largest state in India. Which is the smallest? Goa is the smallest state in India. Among union territories, see, Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh are the new union territories. They came into existence on 31st October 2019. Among the union territories, Ladakh is the largest union territory. The smallest union territory is Lakshadweep. Children, till now you have studied about the geographical location of India and the latitudinal and longitudinal extent of India and the neighboring countries of India, the frontiers of India and the administrative division of India. Now we have to recall some points which we learnt in the lesson. The southernmost point of India is Indira Point. The northern tip of India is Indira Col. The latitude which passes through the middle of the country is 23.5 degree north latitude. The Indian standard time is based on this longitude. Which longitude it is? 82.5 degree east longitude. The total area of India is 32,87,263 square kilometer. The land frontier of the country is about 15,200 kilometers. The newly formed state of India is Telangana. The largest state in India is Rajasthan. And the smallest state in India is Goa. Children, write down these questions and write the answers and show it to your teacher. Give the latitudinal and longitudinal extent of India. Mention the water frontiers of India. Name the neighboring countries of India. List out all the states and union territories of India. Children, do these activities. Draw the map of India with its latitudinal and longitudinal extent and mark Tropic of Cancer and Central Meridian of India. Draw another outline map of India. Mark and name its states, union territories and their capital cities. Thank you, children.